this video, I wanted to talk about my all-time favorite book, and that is Cloud Atlas. For me, this is one of those stories that kind of just changed my life or my point of view on how I think about, like, living. I know it's very deep, and I guess, but that is what the story did to me, and I'm thankful for that. So, what is this story about? There are actually six stories within this, and it goes like this. It goes this story, this story, that one, that one, that one, that one. Then it goes back to the original story, and it takes you on a journey through all of these people's lives, through different time periods. So here we have like the 1600s, and we get to like modern day, then we get to here, which is like post-apocalyptic. They all have different struggles and things that go on in their life, and even though they live in different times and have a different, like, struggle that they're dealing with, we all have this common trend as humans. And yeah, it is really beautiful. The first half of the book, I would say, is the, like, beginning, if that makes sense. You learn about each person's life individually, and then they give hints later on in the book about other stories and other lives. And then the ending, the second half of the story, it starts connecting all the dots between all the different timelines. Truly beautiful story. There are many themes in this book, actually. And my favorite theme is that the decisions that we make on a daily basis, even the small ones, have incredible consequences, or more like influences on things that happen in the future. It's kind of like the butterfly effect, although it doesn't necessarily take the story along that type of thought process. It's more of just, if I make this decision today, it's because everything that happened before me, I guess, yeah, it is the butterfly effect. But yeah, everything in the past is what I am today, and every decision I make now will do the same for everyone else in the future. And it kind of just makes you think about the little things in life and what you can do better on a daily basis, even the smallest thing, because that has a powerful impact on the lives ahead of us. And it's kind of true, right? There's a lot of parallels of a few things happening in one story, and then you see later on how it impacted that person and how they made a different decision. Because this isn't really a spoiler, however it might kind of be. I will try very hard not to spoil it, obviously, but you follow a timeline of people. They're not necessarily decision made by a character in the past will influence a decision they make in the future. It's beautiful. I found this story by watching a trailer on YouTube, I think in 2012. I was in high school, and the trailer was beautiful. Like, the music, the, like, energy it brought, and it was powerful. So powerful, it almost made me, like, cry. Teared when I watched it, and it made me want to read the book and then watch the movie. I heard the book was much better, and I have to agree, the book is by far so much better. That doesn't mean that the movie is bad. I just think that this type of story is very hard to make into a movie. And I saw the movie twice. It's like 3 hours long, and so much was missed out. And it's not necessarily the movie people's fault, the Wachowski brothers, I'm sorry for mispronouncing that, they did a good job. Tom Hanks was in it, Halle Berry, there's some other big names, I can't think of it, but like, it was a pretty powerful or pretty expensive movie. But it's just hard to put it into a movie because there's so much soundproof chambers of my heart, because great, but definitely not as good as the book, and the movie did have, it just kind of felt drawn, I don't know, it's missing a lot, but it's still